Hydropower is the electricity you generate through moving water. Hydropower is such an important resource of electricity because it is flexible, because it's not emitting any carbon emission, and because it's a renewable source of electricity.
Hydropower, with its clean renewable energy generation and storage capabilities, is expected to provide the backbone for zero carbon electric sector and also help with the decarbonization of the entire economy. I'm Vladimir Koritarov, the director of the Center for Energy, Environmental and Economic Systems Analysis at Argonne National Laboratory.
My name is Quentin Ploussard. I am an energy system engineer at Argonne National Laboratory. One of the reasons why hydropower is so important in the future is because it's able to counterbalance the production of wind and solar. When you integrate a lot of wind and solar into the grid, you have a lot of variability in the energy production. It's very hard to predict. When you have hydropower that is here at the same time, it is able to balance almost in real time energy production from wind and solar, so your energy generation is a bit more smooth.
There are several types of hydropower plants that are characterized typically by their storage and operational capabilities. For example, run-of-river hydropower plants have little or no energy storage. They generate electricity basically as the flow of the river dictates.
The water is already having a kinetic energy because it's moving through the river. And when it encounters this turbine, it will give away this kinetic energy to the turbine that will start rotating and then generate electricity.
Storage power plants, they have some reservoirs in which they can store the water, and they are not so much dependent on the actual flow in the river at that moment.
You can decide when to release this water and then when to generate this electricity. So you can generate electricity on demand, which is something very important in the power grid. This big hydropower dam play the role of big giant battery at the national scale. But you may say, okay, but the difference is that my lithium ion battery from my electric car, what I can do is that once I discharge it, I can still recharge it. Well, this is where the third type of hydropower is actually interesting.
Pump storage hydropower plants utilize two reservoirs for their operation.
With pump storage hydro, what you do is that you actively pump the water back up so you can charge this giant battery. So you consume electricity from the grid to charge your giant hydro battery back, and then you can discharge it at a later time.
Scientists at the US Department of Energy's Argonne National Laboratory have been helping meet the world's growing demand for hydropower for over 35 years.
We need to integrate more and more renewable energy in the system, and renewable energy are mostly wind, solar, and hydropower.
Hydropower is supporting wind and solar. It's a crucial role because hydropower provides that kind of flexibility and storage capability that is needed.
Wind and solar need hydropower plants if we want to have a 100% decarbonized grid.